In our music beat, I promise you better music than that theme song just ahead. As one of the most popular brother and sister duos of the 1970s and the early 80s, the Carpenters became known for some of music's most iconic ballads and chart-topping hits of all time. Since 2013, a show based on the Carpenters' music has been touring the whole country. And on Thursday, a special performance to commemorate the 50th anniversary of their debut album will take place at the Carpenters' hometown theater in Downey. The show is called We've Only Just Begun. Take a look. Okay, this is the most fun show, and joining us now is the show's lead vocalist, Michelle Berting. Good morning, Michelle.
Good morning.
Such a pleasure to have you here.
Great to be here. Thank you.
So we grew up listening to this music, right?
We did.
I remember being little and thinking Karen Carpenter was probably the most glamorous, talented person that ever lived.
Absolutely.
What did it feel like to step into her shoes?
Oh, my gosh, amazing. And it started really, you know, being growing up with the music, being a fan, and then of course going into a career in musical theater. And I started to put together my own cabaret shows, exploring the standard songbook and pop songs of my youth. And people kept saying to me, you know, Michelle, you sound like Karen Carpenter. What a great compliment, right?
Right.
So I started to add their songs into my sets, and it always seemed that people would react in such a beautiful, emotional way to these songs. I had this little dream of putting together a show of all of their music, but it wasn't until I met my husband Mark and told him about it, he said, let's do it. So
who is now your producer?
He's now our producer of our show, and yes, the rest is history.
The soundtrack of our lives.
For
let's
sure.
take another listen real quick. Her brother played the piano so beautifully.
Beautifully. A genius arranger and pianist, and really the musical driving force behind the duo.
Has he seen you?
He hasn't. We'd love to meet him. Oh, what a thrill it would be to meet him. Yes.
She was, again, such an icon. She passed away from anorexia, bulimia.
Yes.
So sort of the first we'd ever heard of that.
Absolutely.
Sort of thing.
For so many people, they'd never heard of it, and she really put a face to it.
Her music, though, again, soundtrack of our lives, I keep saying, but there was something about that music. She started with 1969, I guess, so 50th anniversary.
That's right.
But the 60s and into the early 70s, there was still that big sound, too. Horns in the music, as well as sort of the rock drums and stuff. Herb Albert, speaking of horns,
yes,
recently said that of all the acts he signed, because he and A&M signed the Carpenters in 1969, he's most proud of the Carpenters. Why do you think that is?
Well, they were so popular around the world, not only in the U.S., all over the world. And actually, this 50th anniversary is going to involve folks from all over the world. Fans from all over the world are going to be in Southern California this weekend and at our show tomorrow, and celebrating the Carpenters' anniversary. Folks from Japan, Australia, the U.K., Germany, Belgium, all over the United States and Canada.
What should we look forward to in the show?
In the show, we've got, of course, their biggest hits, Close to You, We've Only Just Begun, Rainy Days and Mondays, Goodbye to Love, but we also have those gems that are the album cuts and the fan favorites, songs like Now and A Song for You.
And you're going to do a Christmas show, too, I happen to have heard.
Yes.
Listen, Downey, do they still remember and commemorate her there in her
own town? They really do. You know, the Carpenters lived in Downey. It was where they grew up, where they flourished, and where they stayed in their career, and the town is very proud of them.
I'm so happy that you were able to stop by. I think people are really going to enjoy this. We've Only Just Begun. The Carpenters Remembered opens at the Downey Theater tomorrow night, 7:30 p.m., one night only. Ticket information, visit DowneyTheater.com.